What's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. So I wanted to do more of a urgent update, mainly because there's a few things that are happening within our border, around the world, and within our government. So I want to address what's happening. I'll be giving you a stimulus package update. We're going to talk about Senator Joe Manchin's big move. We're going to address student loan forgiveness and going to talk about how the House passed a bill today. Now, don't get too excited, but the House did pass a bill. However, it could easily be held up in the Senate. And I'll address that in today's video. First, if you enjoy these daily uploads, do me a favor. Go ahead, hit that like button. It really does help out the channel. And also consider subscribing so you never miss an update. But let's get into the update for today. First, earlier today, the House passed a bill for the continuing resolution. This is going to keep the government funded until February 18th. Now, this needs to pass before tomorrow at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now, here's what I can tell you. This bill, this CR, continuing resolution, or stopgap bill, whatever you decide to call it, this bill, it pretty much passed along party lines. It passed 221 to 212. What I can tell you is the question that still remains is this going to pass in the Senate? The Senate is where things go to die. And here's the reason why. I've been getting a lot of questions from people over the past couple of days is why would the Senate not support a government funding bill? Don't they need to get this to pass? Yes. However, here's the reason why. Many senators are saying that they are risking, and when I say many senators, I'm talking about conservatives, mostly Republicans, are saying that they are worried about passing this and not providing some type of provision to block a vaccine mandate. They want to ban vaccine mandates. They do not want this to happen. And they do not want this funded. So here's what they're saying. They are willing to risk about 2.1 million federal employees' jobs because 2.1 million is less than the alternative. Here's what they're saying, and here's their argument. Now, I want to be really clear with this. Nobody wants to see somebody lose their job, okay? Doesn't matter if you're Republican, a Democrat, it doesn't matter. But here's what they are saying. Senators are, and Republicans are saying that President Biden has mandated vaccines or weekly COVID tests to all businesses with more than 100 employees. Now, judges have obviously thrown this out and ruled against this. However, this rule, if it were to go through and this mandate were to stick, this would mean roughly 80 million workers would have to abide by this, go and get the vaccine, or they'd have to go and be tested every single week, and it would have to be negative. Now, according to a recent study, it says 70% of employees vow to quit their jobs if they are required to get a vaccine or adhere to weekly COVID tests. Now, I just want to be very clear. I don't think 70% of Americans would go and quit their job or quit their over a vaccine or a negative COVID test. However, let's be more conservative and let's just say 15% of those workers, let's just say 15, 20% of those workers decide, you know what, I'm going to quit. 15 to 20%, let's say 80 million people, let's say 15 million people are going to decide to quit their jobs. So here's what conservatives in the Senate are saying, that they would much rather risk 2.1 million federal jobs, as opposed to risk even a fraction of that 80 million. That's the alternative. So because of this, they're looking to defund the vaccine mandate. But again, we don't know how far this is going to go. We don't know how many conservatives are going to vote against this. Right now, what I can tell you is that they're trying to get all 100 senators on board to pretty much expedite this entire process. So that happens tomorrow. Now, I promise I will fill you in on all the updates that happen tomorrow. I'll probably do most likely 3 videos, maybe even more than that, depending on what we get, just so that you are updated on everything. Now, here's what we do know. Before the vote within the House today, Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell, he said that he is confident that there will not be a government shutdown. But many have also said that this government, and I quote, this government should be shut down. Here's why. Today, when Senator Joe Manchin was asked if he would vote against the GOP demands, well, he was noncommittal. He did not say yes. He did not say no. Right now, many say that Senator Joe Manchin is pretty much being pushed into the Republican side. However, he states that he will vote based on what is best for him, the residents in West Virginia, and this is not just for today, not just for next week or next month, this is for years to come in the future. So, why do some say the government should be shut down? They say it should be shut down because it's doing nothing. That is why. They say that there's too much divisiveness, there's too much fighting within the party, with party to party. There's just too much. They say that the Biden administration is not doing their job. It would be better just to shut down our government than to keep funding them the way that they have been. So, many Republicans have said that they have completely lost faith in the system. Many Americans worry that this government has a different agenda. And get this, because this isn't the first time we've heard this. Many have said that they are worried that this government, the Biden administration, is or actually has a different agenda than what they are telling the American people. And honestly, could they have a different agenda? Yes. Some say that the vaccine mandates are part of their agenda. Some say, you know, COVID was part of their agenda. I don't think this is. Could the vaccines be? Yes, they could be. We don't know, right? We honestly don't know. We're pretty much just told whatever they decide to tell us, and then we have to make our decisions off of that, which isn't great, but that's kind of the world we live in. So, as I know more regarding this, I promise I will fill you in on all the latest news and updates. But let's get into what happened earlier on today, okay, regarding the infrastructure bill. Earlier today, we learned a little bit more about what Senator Joe Manchin wants and kind of where the infrastructure bill talks are going. What we know is Senator Joe Manchin, he really wants to wait until 2022. He doesn't want to get this passed before Christmas. He's been very noncommittal on this. He doesn't want to decide now if we're going to see this potential stimulus package or human infrastructure bill, Build Back Better Act, again, whatever you decide to call it. He doesn't want to commit to this in 2021 because he is still worried about inflation. And he says, according to aides, they say with the recent remarks from from Jerome Powell and Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen, Senator Joe Manchin, he didn't believe this helped. This actually hurt his decision. His decision was, let's just vote. Let's just get it done. Let's vote. If Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer wants to vote, let's vote. However, reports now indicate that Senator Joe Manchin would easily oppose this bill because of where we currently stand with inflation. Now, I told you this last month, okay, when everybody was saying that we're going to get this passed before the Senate goes on recess. Here's what I can tell you. I don't think we will. I honestly don't think we will because my belief is they are waiting for the CPI data. They really want to see that, and they want to see the jobs report. Those two things. The jobs report for November and the CPI data. That is what I believe Senator Joe Manchin's really wanting to see. Once he sees that, then he'll make a decision. CPI data, I think that comes out next week. I believe that comes out next week. Okay, so if it comes out next week, I don't think they're getting a deal done before Christmas. I honestly don't think they will unless we see massive deflation. And honestly, I don't think that's gonna happen. So, what I can tell you is that, according to reports, getting this bill passed sometime in February would actually make things easier for the negotiation process and the Senate, because right now, multiple senators have argued that their timeline before Christmas is going to be rough to getting the NDAA, that's the National Defense Authorization Act, that is the Pentagon's budget or the military funding, get that thing passed before 2022, might not happen. Some are saying it might not happen. We're gonna get the government funded. That is something I'm almost sure of. We are potentially gonna see we are going to get the debt ceiling increased. Somehow, some way, it will be increased. I don't know how. I don't know what the path forward will look like, I know it will be done, and it's gonna happen sometime in the next about 13 days, okay, before December 15th. I know that's gonna happen. The human infrastructure bill, honestly, could easily get kicked down the road. They could see that we could see this get pushed back. And then obviously the continuing resolution that passed through the House today. Now there's a lot of stuff that has to happen, but we will see. Again, I'll be here every step of the way. Here's something else that happened today. According to many reports, multiple House Democrats, this is Ilhan Omar, AOC, multiple other progressives as well, they are really pushing for President Biden to forgive up to $10,000 in student debt. One person is saying that this was a campaign promise and the Democrats have to deliver. Now, even though President Biden has promised and millions of borrowers, he's provided millions of borrowers as well with student debt forgiveness, some say that he hasn't lived up to his promise because he was going to do this for every single borrower. Now, Democrats are extremely worried, and I've been talking about this for probably the past 4 to 5 months. Democrats are going to be extremely worried if President Biden doesn't fulfill his promises, like the $10,000 in student loan forgiveness and that $200 per month for Social Security recipients. That $200 per month is most likely not going to happen, especially this year. That $10,000 in student loan forgiveness, some say that this could potentially happen towards the middle of 2022, and this would actually help with getting President, Democrats reelected for the House and the Senate. So we'll see what happens there. But many Democrats say that right now, with the Biden administration not doing their job, it makes it very difficult for them to determine if they're even gonna have a seat next year or not. So we'll see what happens there. But again, everybody's pointing to financial hardships. When it comes to student debt, everybody's saying it's making it hard to afford a home, buy a car, save, right, invest. And honestly, it probably is. But those are not the only hardships that we're seeing. And many experts say that just by addressing student loan forgiveness, that is not going to make the hardships go away overnight. Yes, it's gonna make it easier, but some of the hardships will still be there. Now, here's what I can tell you. The Federal Reserve, the Treasury, and the White House all agree that yes, things are difficult. But what does this mean? What does this mean for us? Here's what I can tell you. According to a recent poll by Gallup, they say that 45% of Americans are reporting hardships due to simple price increases. It has nothing to do with their income, it's just price increases. 70% of those making less than $40,000 per year say that their family is experiencing extreme hardships. 54% of those without a college degree say they are experiencing extreme and total hardship. And those making over $100,000 per year or have some type of college degree say they are experiencing in no way any hardships at all. Do you see how there's such a big difference? $40,000 and less, you're experiencing extreme hardships. Over $100,000, no hardships at all. Not seeing anything. So this is huge. This is big. Some say we have to fix this. But let's get into the COVID news for today. Here's what I can tell you. We are seeing more of the Omicron COVID variant here in the United States. Just today, New York State announced that they have seen 5 cases. However, health experts say that even though we are seeing cases, we are in a far better place with our healthcare system and vaccines. So a lockdown similar to the one that we experienced in the beginning of this pandemic is very, very unlikely. However, New York has also announced that their hospitals are extremely overloaded. So it's not great news there. I do want to bring up something that's not in this country, and that is in Germany. Germany today, they decided that they are going to lock down at this time because of their high COVID cases. They plan on mandating vaccines in the coming months, and they are saying that they are going to have a very strict lockdown. Here's how the rules are. Quite simple. Unvaccinated individuals, you will be barred from anything and everything except grocery stores and pharmacies. Those are really the only things that you can go to. It's just essential businesses. What I can tell you is Germany also announced that any area that has more than 350 COVID cases per every 100,000 people in the past 7 days are going to see even more strict requirements, more strict restrictions. They're going to be very strict on these areas in order to prevent COVID from spreading. Now, why is this important? Why am I bringing up Germany? Here's the reason why. The Biden administration has said multiple times they would not be locking down. We'd see no shutdowns. Great. That's good to know. Here's the other issue. Multiple reports over the past about 48 hours have said that the Biden administration has said that no, there will not be shutdowns or lockdowns. However, they have left the door open for tighter restrictions, just like in Germany. Here's what this could include. This could include things like limited seating in restaurants and bars. We could see an attendance limit on sporting events, right? You want to go to that Laker game, or you want to go see the Knicks, right? You want to go see, you know, Tom Brady and the Bucks play, or go see a hockey game? Well, you might have to pay a little bit more for the ticket because you might have an attendance limit. We'll see. This could also cause businesses to only open during their busiest times. And you may have experienced this before, because during the pandemic, we saw restaurants, they would a lot of times only open like Wednesday through Saturday or Sunday. They'd only open from like 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon to like 9 or 10, just their busiest times. Bars, we would only see them open at night. We would only see them open from like 5, 6 o'clock in the evening to maybe 11 o'clock or midnight. And possibly only on Fridays and Saturday nights, right? It turned into a big issue. Movie theaters, same thing. They didn't open all the time. Retail stores, again, same thing. So right now, some are saying that yes, we will most likely not see a lockdown or a shutdown. However, we could see tighter restrictions. So that's the reason I want to be very mindful of what's going on around the world, really, and in Germany. Because what Germany does, we could potentially see ourselves doing in the near future. Now, do I hope this happens? Obviously not. Do I see this happening? I don't. I honestly don't see this happening. I would say it's probably like a 70% chance, maybe 70 to 80% chance we don't see any tighter restrictions. But there's still that 20 to 30% chance that we do. So, as I know more there regarding the restrictions or potential restrictions, I promise I will fill you in on those updates as we get them. Again, just want to thank you guys for watching. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys on the next one.